Hi there, Aaron. All right, so I'm just getting some video for you. We got Mercy and Sarah. We're out in Sportsman's Warehouse doing some training together. So what we like to do once we get dogs to where they're becoming very obedient is just get them out in public and start the desensitization process there. So this is always, it's always a big deal for owners. They need to get the dogs out, and they need to apply this obedience in situations where there's competing distractors, there's like strange men, strange people all around. You need to get them used to all that. So when you do this, they begin to trust you and they begin to like have faith that no one's gonna hurt them. Because I think all this aggression comes from a place of, well, it's always very complex, but I would say the most of it comes from fear here. So when we lead a dog into a situation and we tell them, not only do you not need to be afraid, but you don't get to react in a bad way, they start dropping that baggage and they start being like, okay, well, mom is telling me what to do. Mom's telling me where to go. Mom's controlling the interactions. She's not letting people come up to me and pet me. That's another thing too. When you have a dog that's an extreme introvert, they don't want to be petted by strangers. And so I always try to let those interactions happen organically, where the dog just sees the human, they get time to warm up, and then they get to go up on their own time. So for these cattle dogs and stuff, it takes them a little longer. So I want to talk about that little interaction right there. Basically, a man came around the corner, and if you saw Sarah, she basically just stepped away. So when you step away like that, when you're handling a dog, you create this little vacuum of the dog needs to feel by coming into the heel position. So anytime we get fixation like that, step away, create vacuum, and then let the dog feel that vacuum. I'm just like process this down here. So then you let the dog feel that vacuum, and then they're good. And you keep doing that until they quit fixating and they're able to kind of drop their baggage. So that technique is called the step back recall, and it's simple yet can be pretty complex depending on how you do it there. Got a little bit of a gauntlet that Sarah's running here.
Oh God.